And boy, do we have a lineup, a stacked card for you this weekend featuring the Adorno brothers, Xander Zayas, Orlando Gonzalez, Jose Vargas, and the two gentlemen sitting beside me. Obviously, headlined will be the WBO Featherweight Championship of the World. The champion, Emmanuel Navarrete, the challenger, Christopher Diaz. We will be speaking with those two gentlemen momentarily, but the co-feature is with me on the stage currently, and we want to get to it. Edgar Berlanga, Damond Nicholson. Gentlemen, thank you for spending time with us today. To everybody tuning in, thank you for joining us. We hope that you are happy and healthy. Let's just dive right in. You have had 16 first-round knockouts to start your career. Nobody's ever talked about this. No, it's, you know, yeah. It just seems to be a thing that just carries on. I'm trying to make a joke that's not very funny, but you've had 16 fights, 16 first-round knockouts. Talk to me about that a little bit.
I mean, you know, it's hard work. At the end of the day, it's hard work. You know, it's all the years that I've done putting work into my boxing career. I've been boxing for 16 years. You know, I've been all around the world. I got the most experience I've gotten since an amateur, and now as a pro. But for me, it's just hard work. You know, like I said, I go in there poised, using my jab, and just work off everything. And if the knockout comes, it comes.
These knockouts have been garnering a lot of attention. And your circle that we see on social media, you're hanging out with Fat Joe, Lil Wayne, who else I write down here, Snoop Dogg. How do you keep yourself grounded to focus at the task at hand and not be continually distracted by that circle?
I mean, it's cool, you know, to be around that. But like I always say to everybody, but winning, all that comes, the fame, the money, everything. When you're winning and if you're doing what I'm doing, all that's going to come. So I don't really pay mind to that. You know, it's cool to have that, to build the brand. You know, you build the brand, you build the image, and that's how you make more money. But at the end of the day, boxing is my number one priority. You know what I'm saying? And you got to win at the end of the day.
I'm going to just take a look over here real quick. Damond, thank you so much for being here. You know, you're hearing this and you've been witnessing this. Your microphone on, you're good to go?
Yeah. Hello?
Yeah, there you go. What's it feel like now that we are days away and you are stepping into the ring with somebody who's knocked out all his opponents in the first round?
Like you said, man, it's boxing. I actually thought he was much bigger than what he sees when I see him in person. But man, it's boxing. You know, at the end of the day, that's all it is. It's the end of the day, it's a science. You know, and you gotta have the chemicals and everything put together to get it done. You know, at the end of the day, man. So I'm just here, man. I'm ready. You know, that's it.
I've been here and I'm ready. We drove together from the airport. Mm-hmm. We had the top rank mm-hmm. shuttle together, mm-hmm. and you were very excited to get off that plane and be here and get things mm-hmm. started. What mm-hmm. what did it mean to you when you got the call saying, "Hey, their camp wants to fight you"?
When we got the call, you know, that's not a bad fight. You know, when we first got it, we turned it down. They called us in I think December or January. We turned it down. They didn't offer the money that we wanted. And then they called us back and we came to a final conclusion and the fight is happening.
Last time you were on ESPN, you gave Hart a great mm-hmm. fight. You mm-hmm. lost via knockout. How are mm-hmm. things different this time around? Because this is no joke. We're here in Florida. It is going to be a battle. I'm excited for it. I know yeah. you're excited because I'm just trying to get back to that moment when I first met you in the van. Anytime, you guys were jamming in the van. You're having a good time. Yeah, yeah. You're excited to be here. I see your camp. Mm-hmm. How is it different this time?
Man, anytime I step in the ring, you know, it's very exciting. But it's totally different for me now, man, mentally and physically. You know, I'm not in the same place I was 3 years ago, you know. Financially and everything, you know, man, I was fighting some hard demons, you know, that I pushed away and pushed to the side, overcame, and now, man, it's time to work. It's time to shine.
Coming back to you, what is it about his side, his camp, that this is the right fight for you guys? Because this was your call.
I mean, you know, we was looking for bigger dogs, you know, especially for the June fight, Puerto Rican Day weekend.
I appreciate that. We was looking at calling me a big dog.
But you know, he's the right fight. You know, at the end of the day, you know, we building something here, you know what I'm saying? And it's brick by brick. Rome wasn't built in a day, you know, so we working, you know. I know he's a veteran, you know, he got a lot of fights under his belt, he got a lot of experience, and these are the type of fights that I need.
I'm going to agree with you on that. I think this is going to be a hell of a fight, and I'm looking forward to it. You've got 3,500 Puerto Rican fans that are going to be in the building Saturday night. What's that mean to you?
It's a blessing. You know, like I always say, every fight is for Puerto Rico. You know, that's the island that haven't had a world champion in a very long time, and a superstar world champion in a very long time. So for me, you know, it's going to be electrifying. You know, I'm ready to tear the roof off. You know, it's going to be a good night Saturday.
You go into these fights with this record, you know, everybody talking about these 16 knockouts in the first round. Do you go into the fights looking for a first round knockout now to keep that streak alive? Or is that pretty much something that's just there? And if it happens, great. If it doesn't, doesn't.
Yeah. For me, you know, it's like if it happens, it happens. If it doesn't, it doesn't. You know, at the end of the day, we push in the training camp to go those rounds, you know, in sparring. I make sure that I'm ready to go 12 rounds, whether it's an 8-rounder or 10-rounder, you know, and that's the mindset you got to have because, there's killers out there, so you got to train for that. You got to be on top, and when you're on top and you're a target, everybody wants you. Everybody want to take your head off, so you got to be 100% prepared. You know, we in camp, and I push myself to the limit each and every time.
What do you see over here that you can exploit Saturday night?
I mean, it's going to be fireworks. You know, for me, like I always say, each and every fight, get your popcorn ready because it's going to be fireworks.
Same thing to you, man. What can we expect Saturday night? You know what you're getting over here. There's not a lot of tape. 16 fights, and they all ended in the first round.
Man, boxing lesson. That's it. You know, he's a young kid, growing still. He has a lot to learn, and you know, he's gonna learn it. You know, he just have to understand. You know, these are the fights that you have to take. You know, to get to that next level. You know, so it's just going to be a boxing lesson. That's it, man. That's all I can tell you. And that's it. You know, he says it's going to be fireworks. Hey, you could. I don't play with fireworks, man. I just went to the gun range the other day, man. So, you know, it's cool. You know, but a boxing lesson, that's what it is.
Well, guys, thank you so much for your time. I'm going to have you place your microphones on your stools behind you. Head up front here for your first face-off and picture. This is Edgar Berlanga and Damon Nicholson. Edgar Berlanga 16-0 with 16 first round knockouts. Damon Nicholson 23-3-1 with 20 knockouts. This bout is scheduled for 8 rounds in the super middleweight division. We're going to take a few photos here and then we're going to bring our main event to the stage. Time to bring up the main event. This is 12 rounds for the WBO Featherweight Championship of the World. This is the second title shot for Christopher Diaz. He challenged Ito in 2018 for the WBO Junior Lightweight title. He has won 2 straight since then, but let's get them up here. It is the challenger, Christopher Diaz, and the champion, Emmanuel Navarrete. Let's bring them up. Everybody at home, thank you for your patience. Let's bring up our main event.
How are you, boss? You good?
Good, man. Good to see you.
Guardy, you're going to translate, huh?
We're going to start here, yeah. All right, everybody. Like I said, going down Saturday night. This will be on ESPN at approximately 10 p.m. Eastern time. Champ, I want to start with you. We're going to start with you, and I'm going to have Guardy over here translate. You recently moved up and won the title. How are you different as a fighter at featherweight than you were at junior featherweight?
Recientemente subiste de 122 a 126. ¿Qué diferente eres de peleador con el cambio de división?
¿Qué tal? Buenos días a todos. Yo estoy muy bien, gracias a Dios. Me siento bastante fuerte. Yo creo que ya mi cuerpo ocupaba este cambio de división, pues ya me estaba batallando mucho marcar la 122. Ahora en 126 soy más sólido y creo que me siento más fuerte.
My body was asking for the change of division, you know, coming up. It was tougher and tougher to make 122, but right now I feel stronger at 126.
How do you evaluate your opponent, Diaz, as a fighter, since he moved down? You went up, he came down. How do you evaluate this?
¿Cómo evalúas a Pitufo, ya que él subió, bajó y volvió a subir y después bajó otra vez? ¿Cómo evalúas a Pitufo ahora en 126?
Sí, yo sé que él ha estado peleando en 126, 130, incluso más arriba. Eso pues sí me desconcerta un poco, pues yo creo que va a ser difícil lastimar a un Pitufo que viene de pelear en divisiones más por encima de la 126. Pero no creo que haya problema, pues yo también, gracias a Dios, tengo la fortuna de pegar fuerte y creo que eso va a hacer la diferencia.
I know Pitufo has fought in 126 and 130. You know, it's going to be tough to hurt a fighter that has fought in a higher division. But I also believe that I have the blessing of having the punching power, and that's going to be enough for me.
I love it. Christopher, welcome, man. The last time we were here in Kissimmee, you know, it was your first title shot. Didn't come out the way you wanted. But how would this change all of that, especially with so many Puerto Rican fans that are going to be here supporting you?
It's different. I'm a different person right now. I don't mix emotional with fights, with fans. I just want to make my fight. And I've been in the big arenas a lot of times. Shakur Stevenson, Masayu Gito in front of 8,000 people, sold out, second time sold out against Navarrete. I think I got the experience to be and to became world champion on Saturday night.
I love hearing that. There's a lot of mutual respect on this stage. When we first got in last night and we went through the COVID protocols, these guys ran into each other in the testing site, went up to him right away, shook his hand, you know. So much mutual respect on this stage, and I love that. What concerns you the most? And I use the word concern, you know, vaguely. But is there anything over here that you have to take notice of and be ready for Saturday night that you didn't have to in the previous fights that you just talked about?
If you see my last two fights, I've been a different fighter. I go to the ring to perform, to show the people I can be in the stars. So against Navarrete, you know, Navarrete is a great champion. It's a pleasure for me to share the ring with him. We're going to be in the book history, Puerto Rico, Mexico. But again, it's level to this. Navarrete being with a lot of title fights, but this is my second one. And I can say my third one because Shakur Stevenson fight was that level fight. So it's my time to become world champion. I feel ready as a person, spirit, mentality. I'm so focused that if you can see my body, I changed my body, my mind, and it's everything in lineup to become world champion.
You referenced the Stevenson fight, and you know that was my next question. What kept you motivated after that loss? Because you know there's sometimes not a clear path back to this stage and having a title shot. But what kept you motivated?
When I get home and I see my babies, I got three daughters, a beautiful wife, and as a leader in my house, I gotta bring the food to the table, and this is the easiest way. It's not easy because you got hit, but at the end of the day, I go back to the gym with that mentality. I work hard. My trainer right there, he knows. My training conditioning coach right there knows that I work 200% harder than anyone here. It's just about me. And then out of the fight, the people will see the next Puerto Rican superstar in boxing.
I love it. Emmanuel, I come back to you. It's been a while since you fought in front of fans. What is it going to feel like being back in the ring and having people in the arena?
Ha pasado mucho tiempo desde que peleaste frente a fanáticos. ¿Cómo va a sentirse esa experiencia de tener la oportunidad de pelear ante una arena llena?
And Guardy, not only that, most of the fans in the arena are going to be cheering for his opponent.
Y que no solamente frente a fanáticos, sino que también los fanáticos que van a estar presentes van a estar apoyando a Pitufo.
Yo creo que ya me hacía falta sentir esa vibración de toda la gente en un evento. A pesar de que van a estar apoyando a Pitufo, yo creo que pues más del 90% de toda la gente, yo creo que me da mucho gusto volver a regresar y sentir este escenario, pues este cariño que la gente brinda cuando uno pelea. Voy a estar motivado por ese aspecto y yo creo que en cuanto a esa parte, la presión más la tiene Pitufo, pues él se debe de quedar bastante bien con toda su gente, toda su fanaticada aquí en su casa prácticamente. Entonces, pues por ese lado yo creo que va a estar mejor para mí, porque pues yo siempre peleo lejos de casa. Yo normalmente peleo aquí en Estados Unidos y yo radico en México. Entonces, la presión pienso que es más para Pitufo. Debe de quedar bien ante toda su gente.
It's been a long time since I fought in front of fans. You know, like I miss the vibes of having the fans in the arena. And even though that, you know, 90% of the fans are going to be cheering for Pitufo, I feel like the pressure is going to be on him because he needs to perform for his people, for his fans. You know, I always been a fighter that been on the road, you know, fighting in away from home, basically. So I feel like the pressure is on him.
Let me ask you that question really quick. Do you feel there's added pressure this time around? There's pressure every time, but hearing that,
when I tell you I change as a person, I miss everything. At the end of the day, the one that benefit from the fight is my family, my children, my wife, my mom, my brothers, and my trainers. The people is going to be there expecting a great fight. It's going to be a great fight for the fans. But in the end of the day, I'm going to make my fight. You're going to make the fight that I'm supposed to make that night. And I've been working a lot of months. I called this fight out like 7 months ago. I fought Jason Sanchez, and I called out Jesse Magdaleno. Unfortunately, they don't make the fight. But here is a better opportunity for a world title. And I'll be talking to my trainer. I say, yo, I think they're going to call me to fight Navarrete. I've been meditating for this fight 6 months from now. And everything being perfect in my mind, in the gym, any injuries, any nothing. And I just can't wait till Saturday to perform.
I love hearing you reference the mental component to this.
Thank you.
Not a lot of fighters sit on the stage with me and talk about that. That says a lot. Champ, what would it mean to you to be a two-weight world champion?
¿Qué significa para ti ser el campeón de dos divisiones?
Estoy muy contento con todo lo que ha pasado en mi carrera. Las oportunidades que me han brindado, agradecido estoy con toda la gente que ha hecho posible esto. Y sigo trabajando porque aspiro a metas más grandes, mucho más grandes que esto. Y pues esto cuesta mucho y no se gana tan fácil. Uno, dos, es peor aún, cuesta el doble de trabajo. Es bonito y feo a la vez que toda la gente te quiere volar la cabeza por tener este cinturón. Y pues yo estoy muy encantado de defenderlo. Yo creo que Pitufo va a sufrir muy para que lo puedas conseguir este sábado. Con todo respeto, no te lo vas a llevar tan fácil, ¿vale?
I feel very happy becoming two-time world champion. You know, like, I feel like this, I have to suffer a lot to, you know, become world champion, even more to become two-time world champion. And I want to tell Pitufo that if you want to take this home, you're going to have to suffer a lot. It's not going to be easy.
Can I say something? Gracias por la oportunidad. Te admiro como persona. Eres una persona buena, una persona, se ve que eres bien familiar, al igual que yo. Respeto lo que has hecho en tu carrera. Dos veces campeón mundial, como dice, no es fácil tener uno, imagínate dos. Hay veces que uno trabajando fuerte, haciendo lo necesario, no se hace campeón mundial. Hay muchos tipos que han tenido 6, 7 veces oportunidades de título mundial y no se hacen campeones mundiales. Esta es mi segunda, la aprovecharé al máximo. Esperaré salir victorioso como lo he planeado en mi mente todo este campamento y espero que traigas lo mejor de ti como siempre lo sabes hacer para dar un buen espectáculo a la gente. Gracias, Navarrete.
Gracias, claro que sí, vamos ahí a dar todo.
I want to tell Navarrete that I respect him as a person. He's a humble guy, you know, he's a family man like myself. You know, it's tough to become a one-time champion. I have my opportunity already, and I just hope that he brings the best so we can give the fans a great fight.
Has there been any obstacles in training camp with COVID protocols and procedures that we've had to follow? And now that we're coming out of this pandemic and we're starting to see things loosen up, has that played a factor? You know, having to go one way, come back the other way, constantly pivoting and shifting. We hear those words a lot. Has there been any of those obstacles in camp? And now that we're here in Florida, you see things a little looser than in other states. Has there been any other challenges there in the camp dealing with the pandemic?
En referente a lo que es la pandemia, ¿has tenido algunos obstáculos en preparación para la pelea? Sabemos que ha sido una situación difícil. Aquí en Florida, pues quizás las cosas están un poquito más suaves. Pero durante el entrenamiento, ¿tuviste algún obstáculo para el entrenamiento?
La verdad es que no, yo estuve haciendo la primera etapa de la preparación en mi casa en el Estado de México y ahí está un poco regular esto de la pandemia, no es tan difícil. La etapa más fuerte de la preparación la hicimos en Tijuana, también ahí las cosas no se me hacían tan complicadas, pues teníamos todo a disposición y en ningún momento tuvimos ningún problema para llevar la preparación en su mejor punto, ¿sabes? O sea, fue la empresa que me respalda, Sanfer, me apoyó bastante para terminar la preparación a todo lo que da con el nivel más alto. No puedo decir como ejemplo la vez pasada que peleé con Villa por el título mundial. Fue más difícil todo porque estaba todo cerrado, no pude entrenar bastante bien. Ahora lo hice muy bien y yo creo que por esa parte no tuve ningún tipo de contratiempo.
I didn't have any obstacles during training camp. You know, I started training camp in State of Mexico. Things were not as tough there. Then the hard part of training camp, I did it in Tijuana. And I want to thank my co-promoter, Sanfer, for the help they have given me. Not this time when I fought Villa, where everything was closed. So it was really tough to train for that fight.
Christopher, the odds makers have you at a 10-1, almost a 10-1 underdog. Does that give you a little extra motivation going into this fight?
That always means a lot for me because when I fought Ido, I wasn't the perfect fighter because he was a number 130 fighter. I came up like 6 pounds. He came up like 17, 18 pounds. So the people that know boxing, they know it's going to be a lot of advantage for Ido. Against Shakur Stevenson, he went there and he just ran the whole night on the Madison Square Garden. And now we fight in a 50-50 fight. I'm happy because he knows. He know I'm the most dangerous fighter that he fought to this date. And I'm just comfortable, you know. It's, I got confidence in me. My team believe in me. My family believe in me. And that's the 1-10 that you're just talking about. That one means a lot for me because that's my family. That's my team. That's my daughter yelling to me and that's the most important thing. I don't think about fans that got Navarrete against me because he deserved that. He's a 2-time world champion. So I'm going to be there one time.
I love hearing that.
And it's going to be Saturday.
Before we wrap up, is there anything you want to say to the fans and to your family before we wrap this up today?
For the fans, thank you for supporting me. You guys make me to be here the second time fight a world title. A lot of people don't believe in me. I know I can tell a lot of names, but I'm not going to be there now. And second of all, my family, my daughters, this is for you. This is my moment. I've been working for this a lot of years, and I promise you I'm going to be world champion on Saturday. Love you, love you, my daughters. Love you.
Same thing to you. Before we wrap up, is there anything he would like to say to his family or fans?
Algo que le quisiera decir a tu familia y fanáticos para finalizar.
Sí, primero que nada le agradezco a toda la gente que está aquí, que está haciendo posible esta conferencia, a Pitufo, mi contrincante, que espero que todo salga bien el sábado. Y a toda la gente que me apoya desde México, aquí en Estados Unidos, todos los que me han estado escribiendo en las redes sociales, les agradezco mucho. Esta pelea va a ser bastante fuerte. Es una pelea de rivalidad México-Puerto Rico, que no esperen más que una guerra de mucho poder en el ring. Voy a hacer posible esto, ya que quiero quedar en el libro de la historia de la rivalidad que existe. Vamos a salir con todo. Voy a tratar de noquear a Pitufo. Esperen eso de mí, siempre espérenlo. Como les dije hace rato, gracias por todo el apoyo, que esté muy bien y espero regresar pronto a casa y con bien.
I want to thank everyone over here in the press conference. I want to thank all my fans in Mexico and the USA, my opponent Pitufo. I want to tell everyone that I'm going to be going for the knockout on Saturday. I want to knock out Pitufo. I want to leave my name in the great rivalry between Mexico and Puerto Rico, and I'm going to give it all to return to Mexico with my title.
Incredible. Gentlemen, thank you for your time. If I could ask you to just leave your microphones there on the stools and head down here for a picture for everybody watching. Thank you to everybody tuning in. Again, this goes down Saturday, April 24th. We will be inside the Silver Spurs Arena here in Kissimmee, Florida. The undercards start at 6 p.m. Eastern on ESPN+. This main event, 10 o'clock on the network, ESPN. It is the WBO Featherweight Championship of the World. The champion, Emmanuel Navarrete. The challenger, Christopher Diaz. Coming to you from Kissimmee, Florida, Saturday, April 24th, 10 p.m. Eastern on ESPN. As always, to everybody watching at home, this is Boxing. This is Top Rank. And we will see you tomorrow for the weigh-ins. Have a great afternoon.